Got two envelopes here. We're going to play a game. I know how much you like games. Now, I'm not going to trick you, not going to cheat you. This is going to be a completely fair game. All I'm going to do is befuddle you. Two envelopes. Each envelope has some money. One of them has twice as much money as the other one. All right, here's how the game works. We're going to mix up the envelopes. All right, and then you're going to pick one at random. All right, what I want you to do is point at the envelope that you want to choose. Point at it. I can't see. I'm sorry, I can't see which one you're pointing at. So you just have to say left or right. Left or right. Is that my left or your left? Or my right or your right? It doesn't really matter. I can't hear you either. So I'm just going to give you this one. All right? It's completely random. No tricks here. This is your envelope. We're going to take this one, and we're going to stick it on the board. That's the one you didn't choose. This is the one you chose. All right? You chose this one. And remember, one of them has twice as much money as the other one, so we're going to see if you're lucky. Let's see what you get. What you get? And the winner is Andrew Jackson. $20. $20. So, now you could just be happy with your $20. Take your $20 and go home. But, you know, you don't get many second chances in life, but I'm going to give you a second chance right now. I'm going to let you switch if you want to. All right, now remember, one of the envelopes has twice as much money as the other one. So there could be two Andy Jacksons up here, or there could be just some other dude. So it could be 40 bucks up here, could be 10 bucks. If you switch and you get lucky, you get 40. Double your money. And you get unlucky, you just get 10. And, well, you could have had 20. Do you want to switch? That's the question. You want to switch? You want to switch? Well, let's see. Let's do a little math and see if you should want to switch. Now, when we were choosing our envelope at random, right, we have basically a 50-50 chance of getting the envelope with the most money in it. And that means we have a 50-50 chance of getting the envelope with the least amount of money in it. I'm going to take this envelope and put this out of our way here. This is yours on the bottom here. So, well, there's a 50-50 chance of us getting the envelope with the most money. That seems like there's a 50-50 chance if we switch, we'll end up with the one with the least money. So we had $20 here, and it seems like there's a 50-50 chance that if we switch, we'll get halved and we'll be down to 10. So in one half the time, we're going to end up with $10. And what we're doing here is finding the expected value of switching. Now, if half the time we get halved, the other half of the time we get doubled, and that's good. So half the time our $20 is doubled, and it's up to 40. And let's see, that's half of 10 is 5, half of 40 is 20. So our expected value of switching is 25. And we have 20 now. So we should switch, right? So we should switch because we expect to gain $5. On average, if we play this game over and over and over again. Well, that's interesting. Now, there's nothing special about 20 here. Let's look at this again. Imagine we opened this envelope and we saw, you know, we found X dollars. All right, opened the envelope up, and instead of Andrew Jackson staring at us, we had a big X dollars. Now, again, half the time when we choose that first envelope, we're going to get the good envelope. And half the time we're going to get the bad envelope. Now, we have an envelope we're holding there, has X dollars in it. So it seems like half the time we switch, we'll end up with half that. So I'm going to find the expected value of switching again. Half the time we'll end up with X over $2. And it seems like, well then, the other half the time, we're going to end up with 2X dollars. And we add this up, that's X over 4 plus X. So we have 5x over 4. So it seems like no matter what we pull out of this envelope, it looks like the expected value is higher to just switch. So what's your strategy? No matter what you take out of this envelope, you're going to say, hey, I'm going to switch to the other one. So you don't even care what's in this first envelope. You're always just going to take the second one. But here's the question. How's that any different than just always taking the first one? You know, if you always switch, you're always 50-50 to end up with the good envelope. But if you always just take the first envelope, you're still always 50-50 to end up with the good envelope. So there's really no difference between always switching and always sticking with the first envelope. Are you confused? Does this bother you? If this bugs you, then you're starting to get it. If it doesn't bug you, then think about it some more until it bothers you, and then try to figure out what's going on here. Thank you.